In the previous video, we have done with the animation using the jQuery. So here we are going to learn regular expression. Okay. So regular expressions are mostly used for the validation purposes, like validation of email, validation of like matching. Okay. Like when we set the password, confirm password, for all these things. Okay. So that's why we have to learn the regular expression over here. So a regular expression is an object that describe a pattern of characters. They are used to perform pattern matches and search and replace function on the text over here. So why I'm doing this video over here, because of the reason, in the next video I'm going to create a mini project for validation of a form, where I'm going to validate an email address, whether the name enter or not enter, surname enter or not enter, then setting of password, then confirming the password, password set and password confirm, match or not match. So that's reason I'm going to do this video over here. So how we go with this? I have created already a file with the name of jQuery 6 on my desktop, and here we have to write the script part over there. So we just started here. We go with the script element in the body. Here we just start with this script. Then here we give type as text or JavaScript. In order to do that, I'm just going to declare a variable, say RGEX. Or regular expression RGX, and initializing it equal to, now here I have to give the character or string that I want to search over there. So in order to give this value over there, I have to give its value using slash, then here we have to write, say whatever we wanted to search, that we have to write over here. Say I just want to have write over there as, okay, RE then slash. Okay, so in this my case I'm going to search RE in a string. So here I have to create another variable over there, variable string, and to that I'm assigning a string that demo of, or we can say the demo for regular expression. Okay, now we have to find the result for this. So I'm going to declare another variable, say result, and to this I will use the match method of the string. Okay, I have to use the match method of the string because we have to match the value in this variable to value in variable string, value in the variable RGX to the value in the variable demo. So here I will go with string dot match, and here we have to give the value RGX. Okay, that is, we wanted to match the value that is contained in the variable RGX with this string. So whatever the value it will return, that will be stored in this variable, that is result. So here I am using alert to display its value. Okay, so here we go, save this, and here we go, refresh this. Now this page is says RE, it means to say that it doesn't show that or doesn't return the value as true or false. It will actually show if the characters match in the string, or if we can say that a string match in the string, then it will return that it's available over there. Now here in our case we go with another thing, say we make it REKD. So that's going to be happen over there. Refresh it and it's return null. It just means the match is not form over there. So we didn't able to find a match in the string. That's the reason over here. Now, for example, we wanted to find demo. Control S, save this. Here we go, refresh, and it still returns null. It still returns nulls. As the reason behind is that this demo is having the capital D, and this demo that we have written over here is having small d. Okay, so that is the major difference, that it search is made as case sensitive. So I just wanted to make it insensitive. So in what we have to do in the regular expression, we just have to give two parameters to it. To the, like here we have to give the pattern, and that is in the slash and another slash. In between these two slash, I have to give the pattern that we want to match in the string, and here after that I have to give the modifier. No, I just wanted to make the match insensitive. Okay, I don't want to make it case sensitive. I just wanted to make it sensitive. So here I will use I, and then I will press Control S, save it. Here we go, refresh. Now this says demo is there. Okay, demo is there. So here I just wanted to find, say, another value, say R, save it, refresh it. It says that this page says that R is found in the string, match is available for R over there. Now it doesn't show the occurrence of the R in this expression. As we see over there, R is available many times. So if we wanted to see the occurrence of how many times R occurs in there, so for this I will use another modifier over there, that is G. G means global. G means global. Okay, so matches, this global match find all match rather than stopping after the first match. In our previous case, it will stop after matching the first. Here it will match the regular match after, even after finding the first match. So here we go, refresh it, and we found. It means in this string the occurrence of R is 4 times. Okay, the occurrence of R is 4 times. So that's where we can go with the regular expression. As I already told you, this is important as we are going to create a mini project of validation, validating the form using the jQuery in our next video. So that's all for now. See you in the next video with mini project, that is validation of a form.